Okay, hey guys, it is Pughy here doing some more replay analysis for Definitive Esports, and okay, so there's some chat going on immediately. It is a PvP, and the person we will be watching is Baschi. I think that's how it's pronounced. I'm terrible at names. In the top left position as the red Prolos, and of course his opponent is the blue Prolos in the bottom right. As we can see, the map is also Ohana. So this guy plays, he's been inactive recently, and he said he liked this game for some reason, but he can't exactly remember. So we're just going to go over it, see what he could do better. He doesn't really have much of a goal. he obviously likes to play some mind games with his opponents. So let's see what's going on. So far, the build is looking good. This guy is also Masters as well, so it's not like he's, you know, a bad player or anything. Cybercore, it's cool. It's a 15-minute game as well, so it's not so bad. This also loaded in, for some reason, the older version of StarCraft, so I'm guessing it's a fairly old replay. So, we have one gas, V2 gas. I don't know what Pashi's doing here, he's just trying to stop it being taken. Which actually doesn't work, you can still take the gas if the probe is below, at your opponent's base. So it looks like it could be a... Okay, I didn't even notice this gateway. Actually, let's go back. I went a bit too fast forward there. Alright, so the two gate opening is fine. That, of course, means he's going to go for three Stalkers, which is really nice. It gives you the map dominance. And it was more designed to stop the four gates, because three Stalkers beats a Stalker and a Zealot and a Probe. So it's normally a pretty good build to do. Of course, you have to deny the... you don't get the early Zealot. So, he walks across the map, which he meant to do. Okay. I was going to say, his opponent needs to pull these units. Now, if you walk up the ramp, that's very, very risky, and you're going for it. Oh, your opponent had bad control there. Okay. Some nice unit control. Pull that one back. Some very nice unit control. Your opponent is a little bad with that. The immortal pops, and now that puts you in a little bit of a bad spot. I would have carried on targeting the Stalker myself. So that evens up okay. You've lost a little bit more. If you killed that Stalker, it would have been even. Because you would have lost the same amount of gas and minerals, pretty much. Because you got the sentry kill. Alright, so you're both going for Robo Bays. Now, you're even on supplies. This is a really fast Robo Bay, in my opinion. You have the first Immortal out. You do have two gates, so you're capable of getting a little bit more tech. And you're going for an expansion behind it, okay. Sometimes this works out. There's normally a lot to it. If you expand with a Colossus, you have to be very careful. Like, sometimes you can't get range. Because you just straight up can't afford it, but if you get the extra gas, then you can. But also, that's when your opponent should attack, and the same applies to him. He may go for no range, just to get an extra Colossus out and hit you with that, because the Colossus are more for stepping over force fields at some points. So because you are going for the expansion, you are the defending player, but at the same time, you're not scouting each other either. There's no observer on the map, which is, in my opinion, pretty bad. Because you're both going kind of blind. He only has one observer, which, in my opinion, like, you kind of doesn't need it. You went three Stalker opening. Three Stalker opening is not what you do if you go DTs. So we have two Immortals, a couple of Zealots, and of course, this is another bad thing about getting, you know, the Colossus so fast. Like, you have to conserve your gas like crazy, because you're not going to have another Colossus in production as soon as this one finishes, because you went for the range. You can't go for range and get the extra Colossus on one base, unless you, like, just cut so much. Like, if you didn't get these two Immortals, you could. But at the same time, you also don't have any sentries, which are really important. Your opponent is going for the... Yeah, he's going for the extra Colossus over the range, because he just wants to get into your base, because he has a lot more units. There's a proxy pylon, you have that. See, only now your second Colossus is producing, you're not chrono boosting. You have to chrono boost like crazy to get these timings out. Because the extra Colossus makes such a big difference. So his Colossus is out, walking across the map. He has to wait for that. Nice, very nice. You get the pylon. Once again, there's still no observer though. So, which in my opinion is a little bit, you need the scout. Your pylon blocked, so supply blocked. And you only built one pylon. Okay, there's a second. The range finishes, which is really big. You have two classes with the range. There be no classes with range. Sorry, two classes without range. The fight goes on here. No guardian shield, which is really bad. Do you target fire? Yeah, you do, but you don't. As soon as the Immortals targeted this Colossus, it moved back, and then you kind of took some extra damage. You have to be very careful of that. And doesn't go well. Yeah, it's so freaking hard to actually defend with Colossus against Colossus with an extra base, because you have to put in, you know, more economy into getting mining from this base. And as we can see, we have a big bank. It looks like you may, judging by this timing, you may just be able to hold, because you do have a bear economy. Okay, one Colossus goes down. Okay. So, target fire that's nice. That Colossus dies. Then there's not all that much left for this guy. He has no close pylon either. His unit's all the way down here. Look how much gas you have. You're still producing harvesters, which is a bit dodgy. But okay. You're doing fairly well. You're not letting the... I like the micro on this Colossus. There we are. You get into range. Good, you use the strength of the Colossus, which is really solid. This guy has so much money though, at the same time he could be expanding as well. He is ahead in supply. More Stalkers are coming in, and you have next to no money. So I'm guessing you like this skin because you might go with this Colossus quite a lot, which is really nice. Okay, there's the pylon again. More Stalkers coming in. An extra sentry. Is this one gonna get it? Oh, that's a bit of a bad force field. Got some bad unit control from this guy. Your unit control, in my opinion, is much better. Oh, it's one shot from dying. Oh, this is gonna get it. Is he gonna get it? Get ready. There it is. And we have good game, and nice micro. He even agreed. So let's go back to the initial fight, because I haven't watched these replays, so knowing the outcome and kind of makes a bit of a difference to see what happens. So this, in my opinion, was really good. You get the pylon, you push through. No observer is really bad though, in my opinion. You're mining the from your extra gases, which is exactly what you do when you take the second base, because the gas is what matters. So that allows you to get the extra Colossus. But if we look at something, it's your supply block, so this Colossus is late, which is never good then. But when this range was being done and you had no Colossus queued, really, I would have cancelled the range. Well, I wouldn't have got the range to begin with, because I know I couldn't afford it. So I would have kept the Colossus production, because you could have had nearly three classes out by now, and he doesn't have range either, so it's not the biggest deal. Yeah, he doesn't have range, it's not started, he doesn't go for it at all. He wants the classes to break the force fields and have that deep, the splash to it. So you having range isn't the biggest deals, because even your Immortals can target fire classes because they have the same range. So let's watch. Oh shoot, that was not meant to happen. So let's watch the fight. You don't really... Okay. You kill the pylon, move out. He was also pretty bad. He didn't have another pylon close. And your units stacked. What the hell, like? I don't think you know that Colossus are coming, but, like, you should have a Colossus, like, there. A Colossus, like, there. And then you should have, like, Zealots spread it this way. One Immortal, like, there. One Immortal, there. And then the Sentries in the center. And, like, you want the split, because obviously Colossus do splash, and if units stack, they do more splash. So you have to be careful. And obviously, at the same time, actually, scratch that. Maybe one Colossus there and one Colossus there, because, like, you shouldn't have had range, so you want them in range of the ramp, at least. Because you would have had an extra Colossus, and then when he moves up the ramp, like, his units clump, so you do more splash damage. Which, as we can see by here, like, you know, there's a lot of damage being dealt. And, how many, he has one Immortal as well, so. Like, your units get stacked, and his Colossus do a lot of damage. You do get one pretty fast, which is really nice, but then you target fire, and you kind of lose your composition then. Did you target fire with everything? It's hard to tell. Yeah, you target fire with your Colossus there. Like, that was really bad. You target fired the Colossus, which is nice, because, you know, you get to kill a Colossus if it works out. But at the same time, you got your Colossus closer to the Zealots, which is really bad, and then the Immortals got surrounded by the Zealots and stuff like that. So you kind of lost the positional fight there, which is really bad. and then, like, you still managed to end up the fight more even, but your opponent wasn't macroing that well behind it, so it's more him failing, in my opinion, than you doing very well. You did have nice control with this Colossus, but still doesn't save the day. Like I said, in my opinion, having the third Colossus out and maybe a couple extra units is more important than the range. So yeah, I feel like that covers it, because the important part, in my opinion, is when you target that Colossus. Like, when it comes to PvP, because our units are so powerful, in my opinion, like, the positioning during fights is far more important than, like, everything else. Like, I've lost to people who had much smaller armies than myself, just because they had better positioning, they had a better split, their Colossus would touch in, so splash damage wasn't being dealt, and stuff like that. And that definitely hampered you, especially, like, letting Zealots attack your Colossus is just like, a no-go. Should have really... How many halves did you have before that fight took place? Because really, you can't have too many halvesters, because then you're cutting away from your... Let's see, before the Nexus goes up, you have 24. So you built about 6, which is actually okay. Cause those 6 just go to the gas, so that's not the worst then. I think just going for the range, in my opinion, wasn't the best thing. Like, this gateway wasn't being used. You only had 3 gateways as well, you're on 2 base. That's a little bit bad. You could have transferred some harvesters as well, just for better saturation. You have 31. So you definitely built a few extra. And you didn't even... Like, actually, let's have another look at this fight, because there's a few things, in my opinion, that's just messed up. Like, you have the 2 sentries. Like, your units are slightly stacked. Like, now they're... All your units in one group. Really bad. And then you kind of, like... Oh, that's what happened. Alright, so... As you can see here... As soon as the Colossus start firing, you kind of attack move down the ramp. Which is kind of bad, because you let your units clump up again. You want him to come to you, because you're the defender. And, like, you mess up your positioning, so... See? And then, like, you attack move down the ramp. And then you... Aw, look at that! What the f... Okay. Let's cover that again. Looks like you targeted the Colossus with everything you had. It's kind of hard to tell. But that's what it looks like. Let's watch it from your point of view. So you have all your units selected. So tagged in, and then it's like boom. You right click on the classes right there, yeah. There we are. You right click on the classes with your entire army. It's actually a bit hard to spot. But yeah, you can't do that. That's freaking stupid. You're like, hoop doop, let me just attack, you know, target fire a Colossus with Zealots, even though these units in front of my Zealots that they have to walk through to get to. So, like, you allowed, like, a lot of your Zealots to take too much damage. Your sentries get right in the range. Like, you should have, like, you know, force fielded and then forced the Colossus to come up the ramp to squash the force fields and then target fired with the Immortals, the Colossus. Not target fired straight away. You never used your Guardian Shield, never used your sentries, so you just wasted your gas on the sentries. And this, in my opinion, is the bit that lost you the game right there. Like, I feel like if anything changes the effect of this game, it's that fight, because you didn't micro that very well. You got a bit like, ooh, Colossus, and you take one out, awesome, but you know, there's still 7 Zealots and stuff like that, and you know, a lot of sentries, the Immortal. And then once your Zealots die, you have 2 Immortals, a Stalker, 2 Sentries, and 2 Colossus. The Zealots are there to deal to absorb damage. So I feel like that's the best I can cover this replay. Like, I had to watch it a couple of times just to get that goal of, you know, finding the perfect point of where you pretty much lost the game, which is what I tried to do. So I found that. So there we are, guys. Thank you for tuning in and watching this replay analysis with me, Pughy. I'm glad you enjoyed. Hopefully this will improve your play. Even if you're not this player, please watch, enjoy, and yeah, take care, guys. Thank you for watching.